What's up, gamers? Cryptigo here, and welcome to the fifth episode of Lowering the Mark, a show where I analyze the world records of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Time Trial runs to see how these runs get faster over time. We'll look at elements such as the loadout, racing lines, and mushroom usage to get a better understanding of how these records evolve. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell to be the first to know when my videos go live. Someone in the comments suggested Yoshi Falls, but that's not in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, so I decided to analyze Yoshi Circuit at 150cc for today's episode. On April 30th, 2017, the world record for this course was 1 minute 46.782 seconds, and it was held by SuperFX. A few years later, on February 25th, 2020, that record now stands at 1 minute 43.143 seconds, thanks to the player PP Army. That's a 3.64 second improvement over SuperFX and a 3.4% faster time. It's by far the largest gap between records of any course I've covered, and for good reason. There's a lot to be impressed about on this run, so let's dive into the analysis. Now, both loadouts share a few commonalities, so they are somewhat fairly matched. SuperFX uses the Mii character with the Bitty Buggy Cart, Roller Tires, and the Parachute Glider. PP Army uses Baby Daisy with the Bitty Buggy Cart, Azure Roller Tires, and the Flower Glider. As I'm sure none of you knew or cared, the Mii character is classified as a heavy character, so that means SuperFX takes advantage of a high top speed early on. PP Army chooses Baby Daisy, which means he has a lower top speed, but higher handling, acceleration, and mini turbo. Now, since both players pick the Bitty Buggy, we see the exact same stats rise and fall for each of them. Top speed and weight have been lowered, while acceleration, grip, handling, and mini turbo all receive a good boost. The same is true for the wheels. Like I mentioned in episode 1, it doesn't necessarily matter which roller wheels you pick because you'll see the same effect on every stat anyway. SuperFX now has a respectable top speed with better than average acceleration, but PP Army has a 1.25 point advantage on mini turbo. Here's a nice twist for you. The former world record holder's glider actually does something to the rest of their loadout. Important stats such as acceleration, handling, and mini turbo all get nice bumps, which gives SuperFX a pretty decent loadout. PP Army also sees similar increases and ends up with max handling and mini turbo. We've got two fantastic loadouts for a pretty nice course here, so let's see how this race went down. It was pretty difficult to section off this course because I wanted to keep it at 3 sections when 4 or even 5 would have made more sense. Maybe in the future I'll consider adding another section to the longer courses. Right out of the gate, both players get their rocket start as they pick up a few mini turbos going into the first section. You'll notice that both players hop off the course to cut out that second turn, but PP Army cuts out more of the course, which puts him ahead at the start of the hand section over a tenth faster than SuperFX. Both players take this waterfall cut very differently. SuperFX uses his first mushroom when he is back on the road to cut through the grass section while picking up a mini turbo and jump boost. Some would say that PP Army uses his first mushroom a bit early, but since he took such a big cut out of the second turn, he lands right on the grass and needs that boost to keep his speed up. The boost from the mushroom lasts long enough to take him all the way through the waterfall and put him ahead at the end of this section by 0.124 seconds. The strat for the tunnel on the first lap is to just drift out and grab the 3 coins before heading back inside and getting on a tight line before the head section. This is the only time you'll see both racers not take a good line through the tunnel. SuperFX's approach to the head section on the first lap is different than PP Army's. He builds up a super mini turbo and times its release to where it will give him enough speed to hop over the grass part and right back onto the road into another mini turbo. Skipping that turn is one of the easiest cuts to learn, and it's super effective, so it's no surprise that he takes advantage of it. PP Army instead opts to stay on the road and grab 2 super mini turbos before hopping over part of the winding turns and drifting through the grass between the set of tires and the wall. This cut saves a lot more time than you think it does, as PP Army is now 8 tenths of a second ahead at the end of the head section. There isn't any discernible difference between our two players as they go through the tail section. I did wonder if PP Army did a better jump cut before the last turn, and I was right. SuperFX actually makes up some ground in this section, but as they come through the line after lap 1, we see PP Army still leads by over half a second. The approach to the hand section doesn't change for either of our racers. SuperFX takes a safer jump cut before boosting through the waterfall and grabbing major air before the start of the tunnel. PP Army takes his same large jump cut before using his second mushroom to just barely make it through the waterfall with minimal air time. From here, both players take very tight turns through the tunnel before moving through the head section. PP Army's lead going into that section now sits at 1.2 seconds. I'm going to pause the analysis here so I can show you guys how to do the jump cut in this section. I'll slow down the footage and explain what to do as best as I can. This cut is really worth learning because it can give you an edge against your friends, and it's almost essential in online play. So you want to start a drift right out of the tunnel on this turn here. Then you'll want to charge it until you see either orange or purple sparks, although it's easier to pull off with a super mini turbo in my opinion. When it comes to releasing the drift, you should aim to do it right as you come across the line in the middle of the road. I found that this release point is the best option if you want to do this cut consistently. Upon release, you also need to hop immediately after and turn left so that your kart is facing forward before the cut. Now for the jump. Timing is everything here, so you need to be locked in before you decide to hop. While carrying the speed from the super mini turbo, you need to hop right as you hit this area here. It's the last area you can drive full speed on before you hit the grass and lose all your speed. Lucky for us, you are going uphill and can use this area as a ramp. So just to summarize, get a drift going, release it at the right time before correcting your vehicle's orientation, and time your hop at the barrier area just right and you'll be rewarded with a beautiful, short-lived flight through the course that can put you in the lead in some cases. This takes some practice, but I have faith that anyone can learn this cut. Keep trying and I'm sure you'll be able to pull it off. Let's resume the analysis. PP Army decides to follow SuperFX's strategy and take the jump cut, but instead grabs an Ultra Mini Turbo before doing so. Both racers grab another mini turbo and drift through the grass in between two sets of tires to close out the head section. The lead for PP Army now is nearly 2 seconds going into the tail section. Nothing really special here. Both players take tight turns through this section before making a small cut to close out lap 2. It's amazing to see that PP Army has built such a lead when both players run the course almost the same. PP Army leads our former world record holder by 1.9 seconds after 2 laps. The final lap is the same as lap 2, and since I already gave you a tutorial on how to do the jump cut, I'll talk about another element of this time trial you might have overlooked, the off-road drift. You might be wondering how our racers are able to pull off a drift through the grass section, and the answer is, in order to do this successfully, you need to be drifting while carrying more speed through the turn and release it at just the right moment in order to maximize speed coming out of the grass. Our racers here are clearly able to pull it off without any issues. I personally can't tell you how to do this as I am not good at it myself, but it's just another trick you can have in your bag when you are playing online or with your friends. And with that, the race is complete. Despite a great effort from SuperFX, PP Army takes the dub with the world record time that is over 3.5 seconds faster. This world record was achieved primarily by taking larger cuts, but PP Army also carried speed more effectively throughout the course, which led to him posting a time that has stood for 2 months now. Another second break is likely, in my opinion, and it won't be long before we see some 142s being posted. That's all for episode 5. If you found this analysis interesting, hit that like button and let me know in the comments which course you want me to analyze next. And make sure it's actually in the game. This series, for the time being, is exclusive to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Tracks. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.